Welcome back to News Tonight. Following the sparks over the early morning encounter at the assembly today, the next hot potato was the contentious school fee row. The school education minister on his part said that the newly appointed Justice Pandian has already kick-started the hearing of appeals by several private schools in the state and that his recommendations will be implemented by the next academic year. But he added that the state will not remain a mute spectator over the harassment of the parents and the children. However, the opposition did strike at that point, asking for strict action from the government to resolve the ongoing school fee row.
இந்த அரசை பொறுத்தமட்டிலே நியாயமான ஒரு முறையான கட்டணங்கள் அனைத்து தரப்பு மாணவர்களுக்கும் கிடைக்கப்பட வேண்டும் என்பதிலே அரசு உறுதியாக இருக்கிறது. இங்கே சொல்லுகிறபோது கூட தேர்வுகளை எழுதுவதை தடுக்கிறார்கள் என்று சொன்னார்கள். எந்த பள்ளியிலாவது அப்படி ஒரு சூழ்நிலை வரும் என்று சொன்னால் நிச்சயமாக அரசு அதை பார்த்துக் கொண்டிருக்காது. எந்த மாணவருடைய தேர்வையும் நிச்சயமாக நிறுத்துவதை நாங்கள் பார்த்துக் கொண்டிருக்க முடியாது என்பதை நான் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்ள விரும்புகிறேன். அதே போல அந்த குழுவிற்கும் தேவையான ஆடிட்டர்ஸ் முழுவதையும் கொடுத்திருக்கிறோம். ஒவ்வொரு பள்ளியும் ஆய்வு செய்வதற்கான முழுமையான வசதிகளும் அந்த குழுவுக்கு நாங்கள் உருவாக்கி தந்திருக்கிறோம். எனவே நீதியரசர் ரவிராஜ பாண்டியன் அவருடைய தலைமை இருக்கக்கூடிய குழு மிக விரைவில் அந்த பணியை முடித்து நியாயமான கட்டணங்களை வழங்கும் என்பதை இந்த அவைக்கு நான் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன்.
Moving on to updates from the case of the missing dance teacher Lalita, who was kidnapped 2 months ago. A man named Saravanan, who was last seen with her, was taken into custody today by the city police after the Madras's High Court's advice on the same. Hearing a petition filed by Lalita's brother, the court had ordered that she be produced today. But as the police have not been able to trace her, Lalita's acquaintance for a few years, Saravanan was produced instead. He is now in the Tulamedu police custodies and for further investigation into the disappearance of the woman.
Actually, the second respondent, the advocate was present in court, Sir Mr. Saravanan, and the court very clearly said there could have been no adoption of such an older adult person, and also said maybe there should be a custodial investigation to find out where this lady is. So that is what happened today, and the matter is posted day after tomorrow for producing the lady. The PP said that she could be in the Shridhi, and they wanted time to go and search for her at Shridhi. But the problem is this petitioner himself has gone to Shridhi and searched for her at Shridhi, and he did not find her. Only thereafter did he even prefer a complaint. So now it's sort of clear that it must be something else. Maybe Saravanan knows her whereabouts and is not telling about it. There seem to be no other person who knows about her whereabouts.
Now, even as the American President Barack Obama spoke of economic integration and interaction, Tamil Nadu has been singing the same tune, at least now, but to a different audience, Japanese investors. Presenting the state as a favored investment destination, the Industries Department of the state is eyeing Japanese investment. And the latest effort in this direction is to develop an industry cluster solely for Japanese firms. According to sources, the likely location for the industry park will be the Sri Perumbatore belt. Meanwhile, there is also speculation that the Japanese auto major Mazda might explore opportunities in the state.
I think we can emerge as a major export center for Japanese companies to export to other parts of the world, as they are doing from China. They have done much less in India. And I think as India has opened up, they're rediscovering India. And with the new SIPA agreement, it should give a fillip for Japan to use India as a major manufacturing base.
Yeah, well, I think it has a great resources, especially in terms of human resources. There are a lot of high degree graduates from, technical universities, but Mazda is seeking growth opportunities in the in Asia. It may look into it, coming to India.
This is News Tonight on NDTV Hindu. Still ahead on the bulletin, let the cards fall. The axe falls on Chavan and Kalmadi, but who takes the hot seat next? Find out in just a bit.